And she said, it depends between the relationship between the student and the teacher. And that really raised some red flags. Hey everyone, it is Yamathon, also known as Maya. Haven't posted in a while because I've really been focusing on my company, Auxilium. If you didn't know, I'm part of a student-run company that sells reusable notebooks, so I've been really focusing on that, but I'm glad to be back on YouTube. I might not post for a while after this just because I'm focusing on that, but I'm gonna try to put myself back on a normal uploading schedule. So today, this video is going to be about how my English teacher finessed me, as you can see from the title. After elementary school, I stopped liking English so much just because from grade 9 to 12, I felt like I wasn't really learning anything anymore just because we were doing the same stuff every semester. Like grade 9, I felt, was the same as grade 12. It was the same assignments, just different books, and I wasn't really enjoying it as much as I used to. So last semester I had English, and I enjoyed it for the most part. I mean, I like writing, especially if I can choose the topic. And my teacher was nice too. Every time I'd walk in the class, I'd be like, hey, how are you? Yeah, she was super nice, and she wasn't really a hard marker. And overall, I enjoyed the course. I wrote the exam and I was really confident about it. And all the assignments I did, I was pretty happy with my mark. So as you all know, high school, I think most high school has this, exam review day. So for that semester, English was the only exam I had. So I went to exam review day just to make sure she marked everything correctly and I agreed with everything. English is a lot different from other subjects, like math. You can clearly see if you did something wrong, if an equation doesn't add up. But English is a bit harder just because it's all about sentence structure and you might see something differently compared to how a teacher would see something. So I just went to check my exam, check the last assignments I did to see if I agreed with however she marked it. I walk into the classroom and I'm the only one who showed up because usually exam review day is something people don't usually show up to. So I walk in the class and I was just like, hey miss, how are you? I had that nice positive vibe going, you know, I was in a good mood for the most part. And she was just like, I'm good, how are you? I'm just like, good, how's exam review day going for you? And she goes, it's been a bit stressful just because a lot of students have been coming and asking for their marks to be bumped up 1% and 2%. And in my head, I was just like, yeah, I'm trying to do that too, because I had a goal of getting 88% in the class and I was at an 86. So I wanted to ask her, I was like, how do you determine if someone gets their mark bumped up 1% or 2%? And she said, it depends between the relationship between the student and the teacher. And that really raised some red flags, because how does your mark depend on the relationship between the student and the teacher? But I didn't say anything, I just kept it in the back of my mind, so I was just like, okay, let's just move past that. She gives me my exam back and I read it over and I pretty much agree with everything she marked me wrong on. There was a couple of mistakes that, you know, you can't always catch everything you do even if you read it over. So for the most part, I agreed. Then I realized that she didn't give me one of my assignments back, and it's called the ROL, which means record of learning. And that assignment was pretty much a conversation between you and the teacher, talking about all the things you learned this semester, things that you need to work on, and how you're going to improve. So it was pretty much about goal setting for the future. Before I had this conversation assignment, I prepared myself a lot because I really wanted to do well on this assignment. So I was looking at all the mistakes I was doing in my old assignments and really thinking about how I could improve, just so I could impress her and make her know that I was a person who wants to improve themselves. So I did the conversation and she was agreeing with everything I was saying, and it was a really good conversation overall. I was expecting to do really good. So I asked her for the rubric back, which is, if you don't know what a rubric is, it's pretty much the outline of everything that you're supposed to talk about and how well you did on it. So I asked her, I was like, hey, I didn't get this assignment back. Can I see it so, you know, I know why I got this mark? And she goes, oh, I already gave that back. And I took a second to think about it because, like, maybe I did get it back. But then I realized I did that assignment the day before exam started, so I haven't been back to that class for her to give it back to me. So I was like, no, I didn't get it back because I haven't been here since. And she said, well, I handed them all back, so I don't really know. So I was starting to get a bit annoyed because I was just like, what do you mean you handed them all back? I haven't even been here. Then I was like, okay, well, I really need that assignment back. So she was like, okay, let me go check my office, I'll see. So I was like, okay. So she walks out, and about a minute later, she comes back with a stack of paper and she's like, here they are. And I was just like, see, I knew it. So I get it back and all of the categories are out of 10. And she was giving me like 7.6, 8.3, all these decimal marks. Now teachers have done that to me in the past, but this assignment was a conversation, so I don't really know how you get decimal points in a conversation assignment. So I asked her, I was like, hey, you know, could you tell me what I did to get these marks and what I could do to be better, because I didn't really understand why I was getting decimals. I would have been happy if it was an 8 out of 10, but 7.3, like, what is that? So she was like, oh, you know, this assignment was all in the moment. It was a conversation, so I don't really remember. And immediately I started thinking, and I was like, if you're giving me an 8.3 or a 7.4, a mark so specific, you should know what I did to mess up. Like, that doesn't really add up to me. Okay, well, can you just give me some feedback on how I could do better? I was questioning her so I could get an answer because she wasn't really giving it to me. So she just kept bouncing around the truth and was like, I don't really know. It was a conversation, it's all in the moment. And at this point, I was getting super frustrated because I wanted to know why I got a lower mark. It's not fair that a teacher would give you back an assignment that's all about learning what to do better and you couldn't even tell me what to do better. So at this point, I'm getting super frustrated. The bell rang to get to the next class and I was so frustrated that I went down to guidance because I needed to get an explanation about this, because I'm a person who is all about fairness and that was ridiculously unfair. So I go down to my guidance and the woman at the desk was like, oh, how can I help you, whatever. I said, can I please talk to a guidance counselor? And she goes, what is it regarding? And I said, I just need to talk about one of my teachers just to get some clarification about something. And then she gave me a lot of attitude. She was like, well, all the guidance counselors are out right now, so you're gonna have to wait. So I was like, okay, I'll just sit down and wait. So I wait about 15 minutes and a guidance counselor comes back with a coffee in their hand and she turns to me, she's like, oh, can you talk to this one? I was just like, yeah, like, what's the issue? So I go into his office and he asked me what the problem is. I said, there's a teacher who's refusing to give me feedback on an assignment, and we kind of talked through it and he was understanding where I was coming from, but as a teacher and a guidance counselor, he couldn't really tell me what to do because that teacher is someone that he works with, so he can't just go to her and start questioning her. So he suggested that I go to the office and talk to a principal. So I thanked him for understanding me, listening, and I go to the office and the secretary says, there's no vice principals available. They're either not here or in a meeting. So I said, when will I be able to talk to one? She goes, I don't know. So I'm like, great, thanks for the help. I just go sit down and started texting my mom. I was like, this is what's happening. They're not listening to me, blah, blah, blah. And she said, no, like, this is your grade 12 mark. You need to get an explanation. So I was just sitting down frustrated. So then I just went to my last period class to see if I could like just get it out of my head and think about something else for now. So I go to my class and my teacher can tell that I was like mad. Like, I don't know how it was that I walked into the class, but he was like immediately, what's wrong? So I explained the whole story to him and he's just like, yep, that's not fair. You should be able to talk to a principal. He kind of calmed me down and said that he would go to the office and work something out for me, which I was super thankful for, which I was super thankful for because I really needed to talk to someone before I would literally explode. So he emailed me and said, yeah, you can go talk to a vice principal after the weekend. And I was like, thank you. I'm grateful for you. I need to talk to somebody because I am getting super mad and this is staying on my mind. Weekend passes and my teacher says that I can go down to talk to the principal. So I go to the principal's office. First of all, I told him that the mark bumping up depends on the relationship between the student and the teacher, and he was low-key agreeing with her statement, which was ridiculous because he was like, oh, you shouldn't take it the wrong way, she probably still likes you, blah blah blah, as long as you're not a troublemaker, because teachers don't usually like to upgrade troublemakers' marks. A mark is a mark. A mark is objective, not subjective, if you know what I mean, right? So he's just telling me I should go back and ask her again, which is a complete waste of time because I already spent an hour trying to get an explanation from her. So I just gave up, which I shouldn't have done, but a lot of time was passed by and I was getting super frustrated and I didn't want to start yelling or anything. But yeah, my mark never went up. And to this day, I am still frustrated about it, especially because barely anyone was able to help me. And it kind of taught me that teachers don't really want you to succeed. I've only had a couple teachers that have actually taught you things that are life lessons, and they were actually passionate about their job. So they actually cared about you as a person and wanted you to learn. A lot of teachers are just there to go in the building, get their money, and leave, which is not a good way of teaching. You actually want students to be successful because they're gonna be the ones taking care of you in the future. So you should be the person that inspires them to do well, not just shut them down and not give them feedback and just be done for the day. I thought that was extremely ridiculous. But the whole point of me recording this video was not to go out for the teacher and say, this teacher's bad, they should be fired. That's not my whole purpose. My whole purpose is to say that if something isn't fair, you need to talk up about it. Even if it doesn't end up going the way you want it to, at least your voice was hopefully heard, because you never know, something could be changed. It can change your life, it can change your future. So if anything is ever not fair, you need to speak up about it, because people these days are about money and not truth. So make sure if something's not fair, talk up about it. I don't care if it doesn't end up getting somewhere. If you say something, something could happen. So always keep that in mind. And this whole experience, again, has taught me, you know, teachers, there's a select few of them that are good, and I hope you get to those people because they're gonna make you the successful ones. So that's pretty much how my teacher finessed me. So I hope you enjoyed this little story. I'm still trying to think of ideas of more rant type videos because those are the ones that seem to be doing super well. So if you have any suggestions for me, you can leave a suggestion in the comments or message me. All my social media will be in the description. But if you made it this far, thank you for watching this entire video. I hope you learned something because that's what I tried to do in this video. Like, subscribe, comment, and I will see you in my next video. Peace out, Yammers!